Yeah, really pleased. I was involved in the summer with the senior team. Hugely enjoyed it. Enjoyed building relationships with the players and also the management and working with Peter Moores. Very enjoyable, learnt a lot. And now to have this official position, yeah, I'm very excited about the future. And what was nice about the summer was that actually I'd done 2 winters with the England Lions, and so already had relationships with some of the players, and that certainly helped going into that environment, seeing a few friendly faces of guys that I already knew and that I'd had worked with. So that really helped me settle in. And so, you know, it's looking forward, it's a very exciting winter. I think we have a hugely talented group of players. So, you know, I'm looking forward to supporting them and working with them. You know, in a way, I wish I had been more aware of coaching and what coaching entails, really. I think it would have been healthy for me to see more of the big picture that goes on around cricket teams and the environment. As a player, I suppose I may have been a bit tunnel vision. So, you know, when I came out of cricket, retired, I didn't want to drop into coaching for the wrong reasons. And I think that you know, I got a call from Graham Thorpe that would I come out and help out with the Lions in India. Really enjoyed that, and it's sort of just gone with it from there, really. And you know, I think what's very important as a player, you know, I try to keep evolving and be open to learning, and that's very much the case as a coach. I feel I've got a nice balance between drawing upon 25 years as a player, where I saw a lot of different things in the cricket world, played for different teams, worked with different coaches, different players, travelled the world. So I think you draw upon your own experiences in your own career. But as I've said, you know, in the last 2 years, I've learned a huge amount about coaching, the bigger picture, and I'm very much open to that. So I think that that's a nice, healthy balance to have. You know, as I say, essentially, you know, I'm here to work with the batters, but I also am here to give to the environment and the team as a whole. So I'm a coach in all areas, and you know, you have a voice and an opinion, and hopefully, you know, there's a contribution there as well. So I'm part of the setup. I want to contribute in a positive way, but primarily, you know, I'm really looking forward to working with the batsmen. Of course, we have a huge winter of one-day cricket, and I think that we're exciting in that regard, because I think we have huge talent, and I think it's fair to say that England are probably a bit of a wild card for the World Cup. But I think that makes us dangerous, and I think if we can get the players to relax and perhaps play as underdogs with nothing to lose, no fear attitude, then I think England could surprise a few people. We know that there are areas that we want to improve on and work on. Certainly in the Indian series recently, we want to keep pushing the level of skill. So we know that those are areas that the players want to work on and improve on. And of course, the maturing as people as well, as a group, the way they communicate and understand each other, how self-aware they are. Those sorts of things all come into play, really, if they're going to play well under pressure. So it's not just the cricket skills that we're working on, it's the group and the dynamic as well. And I think there's time for the group to really grow in both those areas. When you look at the schedule and the fixture list, it's a very exciting one. There's no question about it. You know, the tri-series in Australia with Australia and India. I mean, that's a huge series, you know, against two fantastic teams, perhaps two of the favourites for the tournament. So England are going to have to play well in that tri-series. The World Cup, of course, the tour of the Caribbean. Let's not forget that, you know, the West Indies is an iconic tour, and you know, it should be considered as such still. And that's even before we get to our summer in the Ashes. So. Look, you know, there's a lot there, and I guess you know, the cliche of taking one tour at a time, you know, clearly that does apply, but I think it's all done with a view that, you know, we're building all the time, we're looking to improve and evolve all the time, and then hopefully during that World Cup that things will come together.